Well, the labor movement continues to be front and center across the country and here in our state. Actors, auto workers, grocery store employees, baristas demanding more and to get it, walking off the job. And today in our state, another strike. And it's not the only one going on this week. Thousands of union workers planning to picket around the same time, all from the same union, but in different industries. Kaya looked into this latest action. What do workers want and why are they coming together right now, Kaya?
Well, so Jenna, back in October, about 1,000 workers from different sectors met to figure out how they could win their contract negotiations by working together. So they agreed to set March as a deadline to reach agreements with their various employers, calling this a week of action, and janitors are kicking it off.
SEIU Local 26 says more than 10,000 of its members have authorized strikes in recent months.
We clean your building.
And although some have settled contracts with their employers,
we need to be able to pay our bills.
Janitors like Michael Bartos are picketing outside more than 100 buildings, including Ameriprise headquarters.
What do we want?
In the Minneapolis Public Service Building downtown.
Loaf of bread for $4.99. And it just hurts to even see that. That's a good chunk of my hourly wage.
He's one of more than 4,000 janitors on a three-day strike over wages and pensions.
My youngest is 15. He's in the high school, and he has a lot of things he needs. My salary is not enough.
Their strike is part of a week of action. Tuesday, the union's nursing home workers are planning a one-day strike outside a dozen facilities, calling for a $25 minimum wage, better staffing levels.
6 months ago, not just our members in janitorial, but also in security, in retail big box store cleaning, and many other unions, including teachers and municipal workers. All of us together, along with community members, said we're going to set a deadline of March for fair contracts.
It does feel more like a labor movement, like we're all in this together.
McAllister College's Leslie Lavery says this strategy has surged since the pandemic, with St. Paul teachers too gearing up for a possible strike through their union in a week if they can't reach a deal with St. Paul Public Schools.
Their contract was up in July, and they definitely could have said, we're not going to work without a contract. School doesn't start until we resolve this. And that actually is the law in some places, that you won't start a school year till the contract is resolved. That's not how it works here. And so it really is up to the educators to decide. But when we're looking at public sector employees, it's the taxpayers that are going to have to foot the bill. And so the ask might look a little bit different. But if we organize across these sectors, we're saying, no, we're all workers, though, and we all want to share in the benefits of a booming economy.
The janitors out striking today work for several different subcontractors, by the way. And tomorrow afternoon, they'll meet with nursing home workers at the state capitol for a joint rally. Jana?
Yeah, it makes a lot of sense because any one unit may not be big enough, but kind of the whole point of unions is that solidarity.
Right, that louder voice. If that group and that group come together, the message. Yep.
Thanks so much, Kaya. Appreciate it. Let's go.